and for Seattle, Gabby Williams, Mecca Gumake, Ezi Magbegor, Jewell Loyd, and Skylar Diggins-Smith. And we are underway from Seattle. Natasha Cloud up top. Sophie Cunningham loves to check the three ball, loves to hit the three ball. Sophie Cunningham, Jewell with copper on her. Two excellent athletes on the wing. Here's Diggins-Smith, drives in, has a nice seam, and floats it up with the left hand. And there's that confidence of Diggins-Smith. No wonder. It's six games against the West, three at home, three on the road to close out the regular season before the playoffs begin. Turnaround jump shot, Ezi Magbegor. So she makes the turnaround. She misses the two-footer.
I don't even think she left her feet, but those 6'9 length of those arms, just saying no, ma'am.
Oh, good post position against Mecca Gumake. Not much you're going to do there if you're getting Brittany Griner the ball from 8 feet out. The hard-charging Indiana Fever. And still have a shot at fourth, no question. Copper with it. She pump fakes, one dribble and up, and it's good. 7-6.
So smooth. Just such an explosive score. Gabby Williams, one of the best defenders in this league, and she was right there. It did not matter.
Jewell accelerates on Cunningham, tries to draw the foul, and does, and softly kisses it.
It turns into a zone, and so Seattle's got to find that seam.
Like maybe an extra step there by Diana Taurasi, but you're the leading scorer in all time in WNBA history. Here's Mack in the game for the first time for Phoenix. Long three by Cunningham to beat the buzzer, and she's hit two today. Sophie Cunningham makes it 12-11. Jewell Loyd was held to 6 points on 3 of 8. In the last game. She already has 5 in this one. Mack has it. She'll float it up from 15 and hit.
And that's the weakness when you play zone, is that you don't match up on the boards.
And feed inside. Ezi Magbegor slipping in there for the layup. Good backside help by Russell. And then the double team. But Taylor takes it to the rim. Can't get it to go. Offensive rebound stripped away. Kick back to Rossi. Look out. Wide open. Boom. You knew that was going down. She's done that for 20 years.
That's just a layup for Diana Taurasi. Feet set. Nobody near her on the kick out off the O board. And Seattle had such a good defensive possession. That one is frustrating for the Seattle Storm.
Here's Jewell to the window. And she gets it to go.
Yeah, they did a nice job making sure that Brittany Griner did not get deep possession just one time. And she got the bucket.
Gumake, cold to start. See if she can warm up here with the step through. And she does, and she is on the board.
6'4", and crashes the boards. One of the best offensive rebounders in the league.
High-low. Oh, nicely done to Brittany Griner. Seattle a little late getting over. 27 straight games. That is the longest in the WNBA this year and the longest in Seattle Storm history. They have really protected the basketball. Horston goes up and down. Jordan Horston, the and-one opportunity. Phoenix does a nice job getting back. No advantage for the Storm, but they give Seattle an advantage because they just drop off the red-hot Skylar Diggins-Smith. They'll give it back to her. Take another three. No, instead, look at that beautiful one dribble, bounce pass layup. Wow, Diggins-Smith to NECA. That's just pretty. There's a switch inside, so advantage for Seattle. Kick back out, Horston, three on the way. That was in rhythm, catch and shoot. Jordan Horston, not known as a great three-point shooter. Well, they're on pace for about 60 in this game right now.
Yeah, Seattle has played well, certainly moved their feet.
Copper with a little kiss off the window.
It's the kind of luck that you get when you're one of the best scorers in the W.
Oh, backdoor cut. She got copper on the other end, though, didn't she?
Woo! That was gorgeous. Jordan
Cunningham inside, just ripped. That is grand larceny by Skylar Diggins-Smith. Do they pay it off? Oh, you bet they do. Timeout, Nate Tibbetts. Well, she has just tied Sue Bird for the franchise record for most assists in a season with 221. So we'll see if she gets the record this half. How about right there? Skylar Diggins-Smith. Here's Sky. Bullet pass to NECA. Goes up over Brittany Griner with the flip shot, and it's good. 41-26. Magbegor with the high screen. Back to Ezi against Griner. That one's no good. There's the jumping jack finishing. Jordan Horston, nobody has the vert like her on this basketball team. 10 seconds left. All Seattle here in the first half. Taurasi against Whitcomb with 5. Head down. Big 1-2. Lay it up. And good.
At least the starters for Seattle. Nneka Gumake with eight. Ezzie Magwegor with six. Skylar Diggins-Smith with five. But Jordan Horston off the bench, leading all Storm players and scoring at 11. There's Sophie Cunningham starting this one out just like she did the first quarter.
A former member of the Seattle Storm, Katie Smith. Is it a requirement if you're a legend you play for the Seattle Storm at some point in your career?
That's exactly right. I think we talked about that a few games ago. There's like, what, like six of the top 16? Into the corner. Another three by Skylar, and why not? Everything's going down for Skylar Diggins-Smith, because this was by far her worst three-point shooting season of her career. And there's a steal, Jewell back to Skylar. Seattle just having fun. Gabby Williams finishes the break. Seattle Storm, use promo code STORM25 to get $25 for your first trade when you sign up today. Diana Taurasi.
For Skylar after the Diana Taurasi three. So you come right back with the answer.
Here's Cloud, and there's an answer to the answer.
It's the definition of smooth, Jewell Loyd.
Taurasi comes around a Kreiner pick. Geez. Boy, there's been some athletic rebounds. We've seen Gabby. We've seen Jordan Horston tonight. Loyd coming around a screen. There it is. Oh, both the guards just white hot for Seattle right now. 15-4, and they shoot over 25%. That's all they need, 25%, and they're 15-4. They're 11-1 when they outshoot their opponent from three-point range. Here's Cloud now, hooks it to Mack from 15 and gets it to go, Natasha Mack. And Sammy will hit another one. She hit one in the second quarter. Eight on the shot clock for Copper. Gabby stays with her. Help from Ezzie, gives it off Billings, who attacks and scores. Williams gets a screen from Russell. 7 seconds left. She'll take it in with the left and finish back to a 22-point lead. Well, tough to expect.
Well, that one was just she got it with so little time on the shot clock.
Comes in and helps, and the layup with the left hand is up and in. Celeste Taylor.
Diana Taurasi's on your team. She's already got 18 points.
Jewell, step back three, right in the grill of Sophie Cunningham. And it's Sammy. She'll catch, she'll fire in and out. Coming the other way is Copper against Loyd, and Copper finishes. Horston with the rebound, looking for any starters. I don't think there's any out there for either team.
Horston, man, she just gets off the ground so quickly.
Here's Jordan, gets it to go. Jordan Horston's had a heck of a game.
I think Jordan Horston, remember Dee Brown with the pump it up shoes back in the day? Yeah. Like, she's got little trampolines in her shoes.
Oh, she does.
Gets up so quickly.
Here's Herbert Harrigan. No defense at all, goes right down Broadway.
Yeah, it's a break that is needed mentally, physically, recharge, because after that they play every other day to end the season.
Oh, the lob pass, so nice, Jordan Horston. And Mercedes Russell digs out her seventh rebound of the game. Oh, get it to Nika in the corner. She doesn't pull the trigger, however. Russell from 18 straight away. Yes, indeed. Mercedes at elite level against Brittany Griner tonight. Bounce pass and the scoop up and in. Nicely done by Monique Billings.
It was tied after the first quarter, but after that, it has been all Seattle Storm.
Four on the shot clock. Horston's been on fire all night. Why not? Jordan Horston, 7 of 8. 16 points.
And you get somebody on the right side, Gabby Williams, she can fly.
Speaking of off to the races, the missed layup by Taylor, but she gets her own rebound and scores. Fans on their feet. Standing ovation for the white-clad Seattle Storm as Noelle Quinn and Nate Tibbetts give a handshake at midcourt. This one was all Seattle in quarters 2, 3, and 4.